Hello, everyone. You can connect industrial sensors like the 4 to 20 milliamps pressure or temperature transmitters to a Raspberry Pi Pico-FX1N PLC and program it with the Mitsubishi GX Works2 application. Let us find out how. Refer to a previous video at the top right of your screen to upgrade your Raspberry Pi Pico to FX1N PLC. The analog inputs of the Pi Pico FX1N PLC are AI0 and AI1 at GP26 and 27 of the Pi Pico. The analog data ranging from 0 to 330 can then be accessed at data registers D1000 and D1001. Using the screw terminal expansion board, let us first connect a potentiometer to GP26, 3.3 volts, and GND. Create a new project in GX Works2. Ensure that the FX CPU series, the FX1N type, and the ladder language are selected. Verify the Pico PLC connectivity in the connection destination window in the navigation window. Select the COM port of the PLC from the serial USB icon and click on Connection Test. Ensure that the memory capacity of 2000 is selected from the PLC parameters to match the Pico PLC memory capacity. Impute a close contact for internal memory bit M0. Impute move D1000, D0 to transfer the analog input data to data register D0. Build the program from the compile menu. Select Write to PLC from the online menu to display the online data operation screen. Select the program main and execute the write operation. Press F3 on your keyboard to start monitoring the PLC parameters. Observe that D1000 and D0 values goes from 1 to 329 when the potentiometer is adjusted from one end to the other. A 4 to 20 milliamps industrial temperature transmitter can be connected to the Pi Pico PLC using this 4 to 20 milliamps current to voltage converter module. The module output voltage should be calibrated to match the Pi Pico analog input voltage of 3.3 volts. Set up the connection to calibrate the module with a 4 to 20 milliamp current source and a multimeter to measure the voltage. Set the current source to 0%. Adjust the right potentiometer on the module with a small screwdriver until the multimeter reading is 0. Set the current source to 100%. Then adjust the left potentiometer until the multimeter displays about 3.3 volts. The temperature transmitter should be connected to the module and then to the PLC as shown. An indicator lamp is also connected to Y0 of the Pico PLC through a relay module. Since the temperature transmitter measurement range is from 0 to 100 degrees Celsius, and the analog output data range at D1000 should be from 0 to 330, the calculation to determine the calibrated value of the temperature transmitter is D1000 times 100, and the result is divided by 330. This can further be simplified to D1000 times 10, divided by 33. Press F2 on your keyboard to stop monitoring the PLC parameters. Add a branch and impute MUL D0 K10 D1. This instruction will multiply the analog input value at register D0 with the decimal constant 10 and store the result in register D1. Make another branch and impute DIV D1. K33, D3. This instruction will divide the results at D1 by 33 and store the results in D3. Finally, impute and greater than or equal to D3 K33, and Y0 in another room. This instruction will compare the temperature reading at D3 with 33 and enable output Y0 when the temperature value is greater than or equal to 33. Compile and write the program to the Pi Pico-FX1N PLC. Press F3 to monitor the PLC parameters and observe the temperature. When the temperature exceeds 33, the indicator lamp at Y0 will be turned on. Thanks for watching. Please consider subscribing, liking, commenting, sharing, and press the bell button if this video is helpful. You can get the components for this video using the links in the description. Bye for now.